2 hours at least.
Thank you.
Richard Bock, 77, Uniontown, Missouri, passed away Thursday, January 25th, 2024, in Perryville, Missouri. He was born May 26, 1946, in Cape Girardeau, Missouri, to Homer Benjamin and Erna Amanda Emma Bock. Jean was baptized June 16, 1946, at Grace Lutheran Church in Uniontown, and made public profession of the Christian faith in his confirmation, April 10, 1960. Jean was a lifelong member of Grace Lutheran Church. He and Leola R. Renner Bock were married May 24, 1969 at St. Joseph Catholic Church in Apple Creek. Jean graduated from Perryville High School in 1964. After high school, he worked at J&J Window Company in Chesterfield, Missouri. He was then drafted into the United States Marine Corps during the Vietnam era. Jean was stationed in Okinawa, Japan in the Motor Pool Division. Upon being discharged, Jean was employed as a truck driver by Tucker Truck Lines in Cape Girardeau, Missouri. He later drove for Inman Trucking before finishing his career at Yellow Freight. Jean retired in 1998 and held several part-time jobs to fill his time, including Bear Engineering and Hawk Brothers Incorporated. In his free time, Jean loved working on the family farm. In his later years, he could be frequently seen riding around the neighborhood in his Polaris Ranger. He loved his Savior, was brought up Lutheran as a member of Grace Lutheran Church in Uniontown. Jean was a proud American, belonged to the American Legion Post 133 and Marine Corps Detachment 1081. He was a member of the Harlan Social Club in Uniontown and enjoyed all the good times. Jean was also an honorary member of the Red Hat Attitudes as their chauffeur. Loving survivors included a wife of 54 years, Leola, a son, James and Natalie Bock of St. Louis, two daughters, Christy and Mike Hoff of St. Mary, and Michelle Bruce Hoff of Perryville. Seven grandchildren, Alex, fiance Kristen Votava, Gellman, Caitlin Hoff, Abigail Hoff, Connor House, Emma Bock, Caden House, and Maya Bock. A sister, Margie and Eddie Burkhardt in Hansville, Alabama. Sisters and brothers-in-law, Jerome Renner, Paul and Kathy Renner, Alan and Bonnie Renner, Rita and Donnie Colville, Sharon Schnerbusch, and Pat Renner. He is also survived by many nieces and nephews. He was preceded in death by his parents, sister Diana Reisenbichler, four brothers, Leo Reisenbichler Jr., Gabe Renner, Earl Webb, and Jim Schrum, and three sisters-in-law, Ann Schrum, Teresa Webb, and Ruth Ann Renner. Jean's earthly remains will be laid to rest in the Grace Lutheran Church Cemetery to await the glorious day of resurrection promised by our Lord Jesus Christ. The family invites you to a meal we serve in the school basement after the graveside service. Please join me in the opening hymn, number 801, found in the Lutheran service book, and he was there, called Great Bell Art.
Thank you.
Pearl service is found in your Lutheran service books, page 278. I invite you to turn there now. And now I invite you to stand as you're able. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
In holy baptism, Jean was covered with the robe of Christ's righteousness that covered all his sin. St. Paul says, "Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead, by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his." The beloved words of the 23rd Psalm, King James Version. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us.
The Lord be with you. O God of grace and mercy, we give thanks for your loving kindness shown to Jean and to all your servants, who, having finished their course in faith, now rest from their labors. Grant that we also may be faithful unto death and receive the crown of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated. The Old Testament reading comes to us from the prophet Isaiah chapter 25. In these words, the prophet pictures a most glorious feast day when God's people will rejoice that death has been vanquished for all time. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wine, of rich food full of marrow, of aged wine well-refined. He will swallow up on this mountain the covering that is cast over all peoples, the veil that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. And the Lord God will wipe away tears from all faces, and the reproach of his people he will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, "Behold, this is our God. We have waited for him that he might save us. This is the Lord. We have waited for him. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And the epistle reading. From St. Peter's first letter. The Apostle Peter addresses new Christians who've had to endure suffering to remain steadfast, and they, like we, will be richly rewarded. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. According to his great mercy, he has caused us to be born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who by God's power are being guarded through faith for a salvation ready to be revealed at the last time. In this you rejoice, though now for a little while, if necessary, you have been grieved by various trials, so that the tested genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that perishes, though it is tested by fire, that your faith may be found to result in praise and glory and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Though you have not seen him, you love him. Though you do not now see him, you believe in him, and rejoice with joy that is inexpressible and filled with glory, obtaining the outcome of your faith. faith, the salvation of your souls. This too is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He flees because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own, and my own know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father. and I lay down my life for the sheep. And I have other sheep that are not of this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason the Father loves me, because I lay down my life that I may take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have authority to lay it down, and I have authority to take it up again. This charge I have received from my Father. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they will never perish, and no one will snatch them out of my hand. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
God has made us his people through our baptism into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen. You may be seated as we turn to hymn 770 to sing, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Dear friends, family members, There are lots of you. Thanks for being here. Especially you, Leola, Christy, Michelle, James. The word of our Lord is the basis for our meditation, as the verse given Jean is a blessing on the day of his confirmation. The words of Jesus that said this: "If anyone loves me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home with him." These are the words of our Lord. Jesus Christ spoke these words. He spoke them in the intimate presence of his disciples. After instituting that sacred meal we Christians call Holy Communion, or the Lord's Supper, or the Eucharist, and the verse is embedded in what is often called the Upper Room Discourse, or the Farewell Discourse in the Upper Room. And immediately following, Jesus knew what was going to happen. Immediately following, in the 24 hours to come, would be his agony in Gethsemane, his betrayal to those who sought to destroy him, the shameful and violent abuse, mistreatment, insults, and blasphemies. There would follow the false accusations, the rigged proceedings, the incitement of the crowd to call for his crucifixion, his innocent death on the cross and burial, all of which he bore in silence out of his great love for us, other than to pray for those who were tormenting him. This is Jesus the Christ, the one whose words were given to Jean as a special blessing on the day he confessed Christ before the congregation gathered here in this place on the day of his confirmation. "If anyone loves me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home with him." At Jean's baptism, which took place in about the place where his body is now, he had four sponsors, three aunts and an uncle. Two, each from the families of his parents. Think what was being implied in that. Implied and hoped for was this: that Elmer and Erna and their generation, with their pledges and prayers, hoping for this child, a three-week-old child, that he might grow up trusting Christ and leading a Christian life, thereby obtaining that new and living hope of which St. Peter wrote earlier. Both sides of the family, descendants of two of the original immigrant families that helped establish this congregation several weeks after their arrival here, establishing it here February 2nd, 1840. I know yet another anniversary is coming up soon. We give thanks to God for those people who handed on a precious treasure to us. May we keep it faithful to pass on to others. For them, maintaining their Christian faith and passing it on was a high priority. There was the strength of family, the encouragement of a faith community, the one that gathered here regularly. A goodly number who probably were also relatives to a greater or lesser degree. And there was Christian schooling out there, two different buildings, if my thinking serves me right. Regular worship, family devotional. And confirmation, after a period of rigorous instruction in the foundational basics of the Christian faith as taught in Luther's small catechism. And then this passage to accompany him in life, words of Jesus: "If anyone loves me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home with him." Now, every verse from God's word has a context. And this one is from the Gospel according to St. John. That alone says something of context. He, the one whom John identifies as the Word made flesh, Jesus, is the one who's going to speak those words. The one without whom nothing has been made, it has been made. We read in chapter 1 and read on Christmas Day. This is Jesus who, in speaking to Nicodemus, chapter 3, gave us the most concise gospel word beloved by millions. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have everlasting life." I saw some of your lips moving too. We hold that promise dear, don't we? This Jesus declared in chapter 6 that he was the bread of life, and that he would raise us up on the last day, and that he was the light of the world. Chapter 8. This Jesus made it clear that he was the good shepherd, and that he was also the resurrection and the life. Chapters 10 and 11. Jesus, who died for our sins, rose from death to demonstrate his resurrection victory. This same Christ also declared to Thomas, remember we call him Doubting Thomas, and to you and to me, have you believed because you've seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed. That wasn't just any old verse. That was Jean's father's confirmation verse. Myrna too had a verse from the Lord's Apostle John, more words of Jesus, this time from the revelation of Jesus Christ, chapter 2, who had said, be faithful unto death, and I will give you the crown of life. This is the Savior who spoke these words for Jean to carry as a lifelong reminder. If anyone loves me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home with him. By the grace of God and the working of his Holy Spirit, Jean received the word of God and the Savior's faith, strength, and gift of his body and blood. Often. Jean was, by the working of God in him, keeping Christ's word. And God was, according to his promise, making his home in Jean. You, Viola, along with Jean, were privileged to raise a family. And together you were blessed to pass on blessings to them of how good it is to be connected to one another, but also the blessings of how good it is to be connected to Christ. Priceless blessings. And how Jean treasured you, Leola, and would, with every visit that I would make, tell me how thankful he was to God for your presence in his life and your accompanying him on life's journey. Such priceless connections, they can't be bought. But you've received it as a gift of God. I say you, but I mean it in the plural. You've received such gifts as a gift of God. For by grace you've been saved through faith. It's not your own doing. It's the gift of God, not of works, so that no one can boast. Thank God for this blessing often. Christ desires to do the same in each and every one of us, making his home on us as we welcome his word and keep his word. Mind you, keeping his word isn't what connects us. No, no, no. Christ has already done this. The triune God has already done this by working faith in us, working faith through the water and the word, that sacrament of holy baptism, long before it ever dawns on us to invite his word in or make his home in us. Jean took great comfort in his Christian faith as the frailties of age crept upon him. This day was never too far distant from Jean's mind, and he had a listing of hymns. That's actually a lie. He had several listings of hymns. By my error, it's back there. I meant to hold it up. But what's important about those lists were the hymns that were on them and the message they embody, the Savior they treasure and praise, and the eternal life they celebrate. The additional titles are first and lines. We're singing some of those today, those four hymns. And they played some, too, the beautiful strings. But there were others, also rans, I guess we'd call it. You heard some of those before the service. But they tell an account of living faith. And if arranged properly, or at least in a arranged certain way, they really give a testament of Jean's faith, too. Let me share it with you this way. Just as I am without one plea, Jesus, sinners, doth receive. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. I know that my Redeemer lives. I am Jesus' little lamb. With the Lord begin your task. Abide, O dearest Jesus. Let us ever walk with Jesus. Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. Jesus, Savior, pilot me. Jesus, lead thou on. Abide with me. God bless our native land. Come, ye thankful people, come. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. And now thank we all our God. A fitting doxology. as the infirmities of age and their hindrances mounted, it was more difficult for Jean to gather with God's people in this place, which was so familiar and so beloved to him. Over the last few years, whether it was one of the special COVID distancing monthly services for communion that we held, or one of the occasions when family was present and able to bring Jean to service, a few things stood out. Jean loved the hymns, and if he knew them, he would sing them. And he was never in a hurry to depart. He seemed to want to linger in this place, a place that had been home for a lifetime. Jean's longing to linger in this place led me to Psalm 84, because this place had been a spiritual anchor in his life for a lifetime. And we read in that psalm, "How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord of hosts. My soul longs, yes, faints for the courts of the Lord. My heart and flesh sing for joy to the living God." Now, in the Lord's presence, Jean knows the fuller truth of that psalm 10 verses on down from what I just read, that we've often spoken together in worship in this place. "For a day in your courts is better than a thousand elsewhere. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than dwell in the tents of the wicked. If anyone loves me," Jesus said, "he will keep my word. And my Father will love him. We will come to him and make our home with him." God, who made a home with Jean, has now taken Jean home. But what God leaves you with is countless blessings over a lifetime passed on to you. Countless blessings, along with the certain expectation of the resurrection of the body, as we've confessed according to Christ's promise. Now may God's rich peace, which surpasses all human understanding, guard and preserve your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. We turn now to hymn 783 to sing, "Take My Life and Live It, Consecrated Lord to You." invite you to stand for prayer. Let us pray to the Lord, our God, our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, and so pass with him through the gate of death and the grave to our joyful resurrection. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant that all who have been nourished by the holy body and blood of your Son may be raised to immortality and incorruption, to be seated with him at your heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give to the family of Jean and to all who mourn comfort in their grief, and assure confidence in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give courage and faith to the bereaved, that within the communion of your church they may have strength to meet the days ahead, and assurance of a holy and certain hope, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love who departed in the faith. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Help us, we pray, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to find comfort in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Receive our thanks for Jean, and for all the blessings you bestowed on him in this earthly life. Bring us at last to our heavenly home, that with him we may see you face to face in the joys of paradise. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O God of all grace, you sent your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to light. We give you thanks that by his death he destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Strengthen us in the confidence that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, will be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Taught by our Lord and trusting his promises, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will live even though he dies, and whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Lord, now you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies, and whoever lives and believes in me will never die. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Lord God, our shepherd, you gather the lambs of your flock into the arms of your mercy and bring them home. Comfort us with the certain hope of the resurrection to everlasting life and a joyful reunion with those we love who have died in the faith. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace.
In the name of the Lord.
Amen. We turn to the concluding hymn 740. I'm but a stranger here. Heaven is my home.